So what can I help you with?
It's true, isn't it? You and Franky Doyle.
Nothing has happened between Franky and I. The moment the rumors started, I debriefed my supervisor, and on his advice, I stopped my sessions with Franky and referred her to another therapist.
So why were you hiding the bookshelves?
We weren't hiding. We were talking about something of a private nature. And Franky felt more comfortable talking there instead of out in the open.
What were you talking about?
I can't tell you that. I'm sorry. It's confidential between Franky and me.
If you had any integrity, you'd hand in your resignation.
Now, you were just responding to the rumours. You plant an idea in someone's head and they search for confirmation of it wherever they look. You can make people believe anything. You tell me, Miss Bennett, what do you think happened to Jodie Spiteri?
Don't change the subject.
No, come on. You must see the pattern. Ferguson visits her in isolation and she shivs B. Smith. She visits her in the psych unit and she self-harms.
Spiteri is a liar and a known self-harmer.
Yes, I know she did that to herself because Ferguson made her.
Well, you'd say anything to keep your job.
Well, what would you do to keep yours? Anything Ferguson asked you? She is a formidable character. I bet she's hard to say no to.
Miss Ferguson has her own way of doing things. But it is always within the rules. And for the benefit of the women, even if it might not seem so at the time.
I deal with a lot of victims of abuse, and a lot of them make excuses for the people who hurt them. They enable them. And they do it because they think that fits with who they are and what they deserve. You are another one of her victims.